Hello guys, many of you ask me what I carry in most cases to my shore fishing expeditions. Today I will show you what my bag has in all times, the basic things at least. So let's start. I will show you pocket by pocket. Okay, starting from the outer side, you can see I always carry my fish grip. That is very, very, very important in shore jigging, because most of the fish are big and you need something to keep them steady. From the other side, I have a bottle connector, where when I want to save some space from inside the bag, I just put it here, click it here and carry it with me like that. Usually I use the bigger bottles, the 1.5 or 2 liters. This is just for showing. On the lower pocket, there are the assist hooks, many types for all type of jigs and for all situations. In another chapter, we are going to see specifically the assist hook session, okay? Here are some octopus that I adjust on the assist hooks. And of course, the leaders. Different types for different short jigging styles, different bottoms and different jigs and weights. The upper pocket has rope. This I use it for fish. When I go very far from the car, very long distances and hard distances, it's impossible to carry a fridge, an ice box. So I attach this rope on the fish, keep them in the water until the time I will go out. This keeps them alive, or at least fresh, or at, fresher than they would be if I left them out in the sun. The protector finger. This is for protecting our finger when you cast all day. If you cast with a P2.5 or P3 braid, after a while your finger gets wet, soft, and you might get a very hard, you might have a very strong cut. This will help you and allow you to cast even farther. This is a needle. Important for the tangles. In case you have a tangle, this thing will help you solve a very bad knot. This is a stone for sharpening. I prefer not to sharpen hooks, I just replace them. But sometimes some lures, like big silicones, have a hook that is engaged with the body. So with this thing, at least to that time, you can have a very good result, and in later fishing, you replace it. This is a solid ring and split ring small box, toolbox. As you can see, it has many types of solid rings, split rings, and many sizes. So no matter what the circumstance, I will have the right one. A lighter. This lighter helps for many situations, and especially with the knots. One day I will make videos with my knots, and the lighter is essential for most knots I use. This is a handmade by me stick for breaking the braid. When you have a snag in the sea, you tie it on that, it's very smooth and stainless steel. And then you use it to break the braid. I had to make one of these after I changed the gears in my reels, because I used to break with a reel. the braid. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. After 20 times, you break a P3 with a 62 liter. It's a very, very powerful, and all this pressure goes directly to your gear. So this thing gives increases the lifespan of your reel. This is a braid cutter by Gosen. You attach it somewhere on you and you use it to cut leaders and braid. A knife. The knife, as well know, is essential for many situations, and especially when you want to take out the blood of bloody fish like tunas. A PR knotter by Shout. I have this fantastic knotter for more than 6-7 years, and it's still as the way I bought it. Amazing. Splittering pliers. Well, I don't have to say what this plier do, huh? And scissors. Let's go to the big pack. A cassetine with inchiku jigs. A cassetine with some silicone lures, some very heavy minnows, and some poppers. Another cassetine with top waters and heavy sinking minnows and sinking pencils. Silicones. This is not mine. Jig bags. Also, spare braid in case I destroy the braid in my reel, to have 300 meters of spare braid to continue my fishing. For my fishing expeditions, I have finally settled with this bag, which is actually a military bag, a tactical bag from the British Army, and I saw it from my very good friend Giuseppe Fantin. It's very tough and very strong. The zippers don't have any problem with the salt. You can open and allow it to breathe, so no much humidity stays inside. It is also very resistant to the sharp rocks, and the sharp rocks is the reason that I have destroyed many bugs in my life. This baby is now 8 months in my possession, and so far performs excellent. Let's see how many months of life it still has. Thank you for watching. We will keep on with these informative videos, and in future videos I'm going to show you everything you saw in the bag, piece by piece, what we should prefer, what is better to use, which things are better to use. We have so much work to do and so many things to say, so stay tuned, because many new things are coming up. Thank you very much for your support. Thank you very much. Be well.